I've watched some videos and documentaries and seen some photographs and of course cartoons about the world beneath the sea, from magnificent corals to massive groups of colorful fish swimming around in the crystal clear water. But I always had a question. Do fish have a home? The answer to that is yes, reefs. Home to most marine life is in reefs. Apart from natural reefs, sunken ships that are hundreds or even thousands of years old have become ideal habitats for oceanic organisms. But how?
ExplaiNing!
Ever since the human race started to explore the enormous blue ocean, there have been sunken ships, and the shipwrecks on the ocean floor mark where the voyagers met their tragic ends. It's estimated that there are over 3 million shipwrecks scattered across the seafloor. Ships that sunk in the sunlight zone, which is the top 200 meters of the ocean, are more likely to form reefs, as there's much more oxygen and sunlight in the shallower sea area. The wrecks add new structures that provide nooks and crannies for the marine life to inhabit, which is mostly what coral reefs and kelp forests offer to fish in the undersea world. The first to make a home on sunken ships is normally algae. They supply glucose, glycerol, and amino acids, which are the products of photosynthesis, to corals. And the steel wreckage provides a perfect surface for coral larvae to attach themselves on, and the currents curling around a sunken structure push up clouds of plankton. This attracts fish like sardines, which in turn entice sharks and larger predators to hang around. And to a lot of people's surprise, a sunken shipwreck can create an ecosystem that hosts over 100 species of undersea creatures. In 2021, a bronze naval ram that sunk 2,200 years ago was found off the coast of Sicily, with 114 different invertebrate species in total living together. In fact, some shipwrecks have been intentionally sunk into the ocean to form new habitats. In a research published on Nature, shows that on some reefs located deeper than 25 meters, numbers of tropical fish on artificial reefs exceeded those on natural reefs, and artificial reefs supported more subtropical fish than natural reefs. But not all shipwrecks can do the same. When we see wreck pictures of the renowned Titanic or the recently found Endurance, they look pretty dead. That's because we don't really see anything else other than the corroded hulls. One big reason is that these two ships both lay on the seabed that's 3,000 to 4,000 meters deep. Ocean depths greater than 1,000 meters are completely devoid of light and oxygen, and photosynthesis does not take place. So obviously, marine life, except microorganisms, are significantly less on the wrecks. So can shipwrecks last a lot longer in the deep sea if there isn't any disturbance from the sea life? Not really. Even though seawater normally gets less corrosive in the deeper sea area, there is a corrosion rate peak located close to the submerged zone and subsoil zone junction. Most of the ships would plunge into the sea mud due to gravity, which left the holes in the peak area. And that explains why a steel giant like the Titanic could be almost decomposed in only 100 years' time. But of course, there are downsides to sunken ships. When a large vessel scrapes the seafloor, it can damage close to 1,000 square meters of ocean habitats. While there are still unanswered questions about what impact these structures have on a larger ocean ecosystem, like if the wreckage helps increase the fish population or they just pull them from somewhere else, or what the order is for different sea animals to arrive to colonize the wrecks, one thing is for sure. Artificial reefs can be paradise for marine life. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more ExplaiNing. I'm Ning. I'll see you next time.